What do I want to be remembered for? When you are able to give answers to this question, your purpose is clearly defined, then you are on your way to success. 2013, to say precisely, on the 13th of September, I came to Finland. When I came to Finland, I came to study. I got to AMK, University of Applied Sciences, studying mechanical engineering and production technology. I met with my studies counselor and I told her that as much as I understood my purpose, why I am here, I want to graduate in time. A study that will take like 4 years, I want to do it in a year or within 2 years. And she told me, Henry, it is not possible. You don't need to be in a hurry. You can take your time and graduate whenever you want. And I told her, yes, but I know my purpose. I know why I am here. I know why I am in school. So as much as I can graduate faster, it will be my honor and pleasure too. She said, it is not possible. I went back to my apartment, took it to the Lord in prayers, and I got a conviction in my spirit that it is possible. So when I got that word in my spirit that it is possible, it stirred up some fires in me. I was determined to see that I succeed. I never went to work after some time. What do I do next is the next step to success. And that is, after you discover your purpose, you have an understanding of where you are going, who you are. The next thing that will be a key to your success is having a plan. The plan, I call it the roadmap. It is from where you are to where you want to be. The plan is a detailed structure, is a detail of where you are, where you are going, and where you want to be. In 5-10 years time, if I see you, where will I meet you? Having a plan of your life, a plan for the future, a plan that shows you where you are going, how you will get there, it's another key to success. So what do? I never went to my study counselor anymore. I took pen and paper in Habakkuk chapter 2, permit me to use scriptures. The Bible says, write the vision and make it plain, that it may warn as many that read it. Even though it tarries, wait for it, it will speak. Why? Because the vision is for appointed time. I wrote down my plans. I wrote down what I want to do. How will I, in my first year, graduate in 2 years' time? I saw that in the study structure in AMK University then in 2013, as a first-year student, you can do courses in second year, third year, and final year. So what do? I put pen to paper. I write the structure that from my first year, I will do my fourth year courses. In my second year, I will do my third year courses. And in my summer, I will do summer courses and graduate. By the time I have that detailed plan, I put the courses that I am going to do. It gave me a clearer picture when I was like, wow, to graduate, you needed 240 credits. And when I check the courses I will be doing with my summer studies, I will be having at least 260. I went back to my study counselor. I have a detailed plan of how I will achieve my academic goals. And she told me again, Henry, it is not possible. What do you do when people say to you, it is not possible? Ignore them. Let your success convince them. Let your success prove to them that it is possible. Every great achiever in life, somehow, someday, at some point, they've been told it is not possible. So what they did, they ignore the naysayers. They ignore the people that don't believe in them. They ignore even those that doubt them. And their success spoke louder than words. And today, they are celebrating. If you want to be a great achiever, number one, have a clear purpose. Understand who you are, what you want to do, what you want to be, what you want to achieve. Number two, have a detailed plan. Not just a plan, a detailed plan. I flew all the way from Nigeria to Finland and I discovered the flight never left Abuja Airport to Helsinki without a flight plan. There is a detailed flight plan from Africa to Europe through The Mediterranean, a deepest flight plan. Here we are in this auditorium, in my research, preparing for this study, preparing for this conference. I discovered that this structure is not here without a deepest structural plan. Why will you live your life without a deepest structural plan? What I'm trying to say is to charge us, if you want to become successful, have a detailed plan of what you want to do, what you want to achieve, how will you get there? That is another key. Number two, what do you do when you have the detailed plan? That leads to number 3 point, have a preparation. Number three, prepare for it. Two more and I'll be through with this short teaching. Number three is to prepare for it. In 2 Chronicles chapter 27 verse 6, the Bible talks about Jotham became great and mighty because he prepared his way before the Lord. There is no achievement without preparation, either consciously or unconsciously. There is a general proverb that failing to plan is planning to fail. But when you have a plan and you don't prepare to see that it is achieved, somewhere in between, you will not get it to the maximum. So what do? You begin to prepare. And 3 ways you can prepare is, number one, give yourself to training. When I knew that I was called into ministry and not into business, I told my pastor then in Nigeria, I'm called into pastor and not into business. And I don't want to go the way every other pastor have gone. I want to be successful. I want to be, when they begin to mention the names of pastor, at least my name should be there. Not by ambition, but just a way to cause impact and reach out to people. And he said, Aaron, you know what? Prepare for it. What do I do in my way of preparation? I gave myself to mentorship. I started pastoring with him and training. While I was to come to Finland, I was privileged to be connected to Bishop Isaac Thomas, sitting right in front of me. I was privileged to be connected to him. And when I came, I went to start pastoring with him. And guess what? It was a plus to me into ministry in Finland. I learned so much under his training. He never gave me 1 euro. I wasn't there for salary. I wasn't there because I want to be paid. What am I trying to say? In your preparation, don't look for money. When you become successful, you will be paid much more. But when you go for money and miss out in the preparation process, then you lose the honor and the reward that come after. Today, I have gotten much more than he would have paid me while I'm with him. Preparation. In your preparation, give yourself to personal development. When you go through the 4 walls of the university of any tertiary institution, you learn the normal academic things. Everyone have equal right to that learning. But when you step out of the bus, develop yourself. Develop yourself. Increase your capacity. When you do that in your preparation time, guess what will happen? When it comes to the season of your manifestation and your show up, you will be more paid than you were when you started. So stay true the preparation time. For you to be able to succeed in life, in any career, my friend, prepare for it. Whatever you are going for, don't ignore the place of preparation. Lastly, on preparation, the place of preparation is the place of baking. I read this article some time back about a butterfly that was in the cocoon. When the butterfly was inside that cocoon trying to develop and prepare to become a better butterfly, someone looked at it in that cocoon and decided to help the butterfly. When they begin to pick up the chair, they never knew that it was the wings and the feather of the butterfly they were peeling off. At the end of the day, the process was short-circuit, and the butterfly, instead of becoming a butterfly, it ended up as a millipede, crawling all the way instead of flying. What am I trying to say? Never jump the process of preparation. It may be challenging. Guess what? For gold to become gold, it goes through the preparation process of refining. If it does not go through that preparation process, it will never become the gold we admire. So in your preparation process, stay calm, stay cool. It's just a matter of time. It's just a matter of time. I said to myself, in 5 years' time from now, with my detailed plan, someone will pay me what more than I would have labored for working for someone. So I stayed in my preparation time. 5 years from now, what will you be doing? What will I be doing? It's all in the process of preparation. All in the process of preparation. Lastly, as I try to round off my talk about the secrets to success, achievers' secrets to success, the last I will be talking about is pursuits. Pursuit talks brings about having the determination to make decisions and take actions. Early this year, I told my church people, never begin the year without a plan. My member will tell me, Pastor, you told us, have a plan. This is my plan. I said, yes, it is not enough having the plan. You must begin to pursue it. Nothing in life just happened. In life, there are three kinds of people. They are spectators. They are fans, they are participants. The World Cup is going on. As I tried to watch and I was discouraged, why? Because no fan get gold medals. Even the spectators watching, oh, Messi did not score, Messi did not do well, they will not get one medal. It is those that are in the field that are playing the game that become successful that get medals. What am I trying to say? In your pursuit, you consciously make decisions and go after it. If it will cost you, no matter the cost, you are willing to pay the price to see that you become who you want to be. You are willing to ignore anything and sacrifice to see that that which you want to be, that which you want to do is achieved. And my friend, I tell you this good news. When you become successful, oh my God, when you become successful, the sky is not just the limit, it's the stepping stone. I say this as a point of rounding off. I am not where I want to be, but I am not where I used to be. Somehow in the process, I have seen God lift me from level to level. When I left Africa coming to Europe as a young pastor, there are people that when I call their phone number, they will switch it off. They will cut off the phone. But when they heard that he has gone abroad, it's not just abroad, he's in Europe. He studied mechanical engineering. He's a young pastor. He's doing great. They saw my posters. They saw the conference. Guess what? They asked for my number, put a call across. Pastor, when are you coming to Nigeria? Where will you be in Africa? Please, can we have dinner with you? I will not look at my schedule and say, can I check the time? Can I look at the time? Oh, that time is not convenient. But guess what? While I was in the ground, while I was coming up, I was the one looking for them. So I've discovered that when you pursue your goal, when you become successful in that trade, in that career, in that profession, in that business, in that ministry, when you become successful, my friend, the sky is not just the limit. You become a celebrity. Many people that you would have gone after will want to meet with you. You become an inspiration to people. You become a blessing to people, imparting life and reaching out to others. So these are some of the secrets. There are so much I can't exhaust them on just this conference, but I will just go through them as a summary so you can take them home. Number one, I said you should have a purpose. Can you say purpose? Number two, have a plan. Can you tell your neighbor, have a plan? Number three is preparation. Prepare for that purpose. Prepare for it. And lastly, pursue it. Pursue it. When I told my study counselor I want to graduate in time, and she said, no, I pursue it. In my first year in Finland, I never knew what they call bar. I never knew what they call beer parlor or nightclub. My life was school, church, work, school, church, work, school, church, work, triangle. So people say to me, you are foolish, you don't know what you're doing. But guess what? After 1 year, I got 140 credits. I needed 240 to graduate. By the second year after my summer courses, I got 200. I went back to my study counselor to say, counselor, can you check my study plan, my PSP? I want to graduate. When she checked it, she was like, wow, Eric, congratulations, you've made it. And guess what? In 2 years, as I planned, I graduated. I applied for graduation, and today I am a graduate. I didn't just call 1, 2, 3. No, I graduated with a good grade. Why? Because I pursue it. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you there is no limit to what you can be, do, or have. So go for your goals. Go for your dream. Go for what you believe, whatever it is. And together, we will meet at the top. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pastor Henry.